What's up, ladies and gentlemen? It's at the town. Tune Rob back again for another trove. I know that it has been quite a while since we got to this. Look at the beautiful Ice Sage, or Ice Mage, that's what I'm calling him. It has been quite a while, so there are quite a few things that I need to actually explain. And you know what? In the meantime, let me double check. Yep, that dungeon is still good, so let's go to it while I'm kind of talking and explaining stuff. Now, for those that don't know and only tune into this series and not my other videos or anything like that, my computer went on the fritz. My power supply ended up expiring, and, well, with that, my computer ended up going down for a little while. So, I don't have any multiple jumps on this guy. So, I didn't get to record or play Trove or do quite a bit of other series, so I need to record a bunch. And what ended up happening was I was kind of pushing Trove episodes for a little while. For now, we've kind of had this series on every second day. And then suddenly I changed that so it was every day, just for a little bit, because I wanted to... Hello, random person. Because for a little bit, I wanted to have our episodes catch up so that we could actually play on our beautiful Ice Mage. Because this is a new class, not so much new anymore, maybe about two weeks. I think it's been out for 2 weeks, this update. And it's actually a really cool class. They've nerfed him a little bit, but otherwise he is still very overpowered and still my second favorite next to the Dracolite. And there's quite a few reasons why. Now, one of the things is that is immediately apparent, which you may not actually notice or anything like that, but is... As soon as we tag enemies with our basic attacks and stuff like that, they are actually slower in their movement. Yes, it is absolutely awesome. We are level 12, by the way. I've actually been playing on this guy for quite a bit. Unfortunately, I didn't get any chance to record him, but I still kept playing anyway because, you know, why not? His basic attack slows down enemies, so that is really good for kiting. It is absolutely awesome and really reminds me of Diablo 2 with all the ice spells and stuff like that. If you're facing a boss one-on-one, this guy is pretty formidable because if you tag the enemy, they're slow enough that you can outrun them. So, very, very handy. The other abilities that this guy has is his right-click move. As you can kind of see, it's a little bit tricky to see. But we're tagging a spot on the ground, that's why you'll find that playing as this class, you're aiming down an awful lot, because that's where the ability goes. Like, see, if you aim down, there it goes, and it's a nice, beautiful icicle, and that is an AoE that does pretty good damage. One of the things that it was doing at first, before they end up nerfing him, was you could actually cast it, like, constantly without any aethers or anything like that. But they've changed it now, so it does actually have a cooldown, a little bit more optimal as far as the class is concerned. Oh, we just got a rainbow. I hope it's good, but I very much doubt it. He is still extremely powerful with his abilities, though. You know, just his added damage and everything like that. And that smackdown move is just, it's still very powerful, especially because it's just his basic right-click attack, so you can spam the heck out of it. The other ability that you see on us this pretty much this whole time is this barrier. Now, this thing has been changed quite a bit since its original conception. Where, at first, like, the way that works is Frozen Ward buffs movement and damage and absorbs the next big attack. Now, it doesn't actually tell you, but at first, it was like it says, where it's like the next time you would get hit, it would get taken off. You could recast it, but it was very annoying because you'd have to constantly recast it. We are pretty much, like, stronger in all manner. We're faster, we got stronger attacks. He's just all powerful when he's rocking this barrier. That was a really cool looking weapon. And what they ended up changing, you can find on their forums and stuff like that, not actually in the game, which is a little bit disappointing, is they've changed it so that now only, I think it's something like you can, it's a little bit finicky in the way they explain it, where you can absorb 10% of your total health of damage. So I think if an enemy attacks anywhere over 10% of your natural health, so like bosses, for example, then the barrier actually gets knocked off. Otherwise, it doesn't do much of anything. I'm not exactly sure how it is explained or something like that, but it's something like that. Now, this guy's ultimate on top of it, which we are actually going to use here, is so overpowered. We cast it, it freezes the enemy, freezes anything around us, and you see that his health bar wasn't moving, but we are still, rest assured, we are still stacking damage. So it's like, if you're damaging an enemy enough while they're frozen, they will end up waking up from their frozen life and find out that they're dead. That is so cruel, that is so mean. Because we're stacking damage as they're frozen, so it's just bang, 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 and then when they come out of the frozen, it like explodes, it does a huge pile of damage, and just bang, and that's it. They're done. The Ice Mage is beautiful. Hello, beautiful Ice Fortress. Also, right now, these are going on because of all the holiday stuff where it's like these little presents and you can actually get a golden key, but you have to pay real life cash for. So I just keep doing this. Nice. You got a common Snowfest surprise. Okay. What did we get? We got a Neon City ice cube. Where are those? Are those? Oh, they must be a crafting recipe or something. Cause I haven't seen those anywhere at all. But either way, this guy is really, really cool. Another thing too about this update, which is actually very unfortunate for us, is that in the mounts, it ended up unlocking Pember. So this is a new mount that you have to have Pemblock for. So with that, Pemblock skyrocketed in price. So I don't think we're going to end up getting our Pember anytime soon. It is very unfortunate. But maybe as the prices go down, potentially. But as for right now, I mean, I keep checking on the forums and stuff like that. But ultimately, nobody is selling me one anymore. At first, they were selling for, I think it was like 3 to 4K flux. And now they're moving up from 6 to 8K. So, no thanks. That is just completely overpriced. It is ridiculous. I am not going to pay that much. And we don't have that much even if we wanted to. So it's just not gonna happen. Wow, look how overpowered this guy is. I mean, granted, we are like level 12 and we're in U1 for the dungeon. So technically we are overpowered here, but that's okay. Whoa, Gadzook says, stay away from me. Oh, I almost forgot too, the big joke that I was gonna do with this guy, cause look at his style. Hello, I am the doctor. I am the Ice Mage, and I use all of my special powers to freeze the enemies. I should have opened with that. Is this some guy's plot? I think it is. But you know what? Another thing too, which I have actually been mentioning. Get out of here, enemy! Get out! See, this is what I do. I kind of just spam our ability. Sometimes it's laggy and doesn't really work, and then other times we can kill things super duper quick. I think it depends whether or not our ice ability hits them directly or not. But the other thing too is I am still, of course, going for all the Shapestone because we were running low for quite a bit. I don't know if I had talked about that on camera. It might have been a long enough time. But I ended up finding someone else that I randomly ended up grouping with. And it was actually awesome because they were not against gathering ore. So it's like, one of the things that is absolutely awesome about this game that a lot of people in this game don't seem to realize is that all of the loot and everything, including what you dig, is shared. So what that means is you're getting twice as much ore if you're digging with another person. So I've taken it upon myself where it's like whenever I'm hanging out with other people, I just start digging and hopefully they don't end up running off too quickly to try and, you know, get to the next dungeon and stuff like that. Because otherwise I've run into quite a few people that are kind of team players and they'll be like, oh, I want to get the ore too, because everybody needs the ore. Everybody. And I ended up getting, actually, you know what? Let's see. Personal chest. I like this guy's house. It's kind of cool. Kind of cozy. Kind of cozy. There's nothing to it. But in our we don't need to check our chest. We have 772 shape stone. Finally, our flux has been going up gradually. I'm still trying my best to do my dailies. Sometimes it just doesn't happen. Let's get these trove chests out of the way. We are going to call today's episode right after this. Let's see if we got anything worthwhile. Nope. Because now that's the other thing too, why we're barely going to find anything good on this character. Is now that we are him, now that we ended up getting to level 10, we got access to some of our older shadow gear, and our rainbow staff from a million years ago and our Dracolite. So it is absolutely wonderful. Another thing, too, that I finally ended up unlocking, oh my goodness, is down in here, not lava fishing, none of that stuff. No, 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 no. Promo? No. We got this. We got the Shadome, which is absolutely awesome. Look at that. It is cool, which I think maybe we'll start using it on, I don't know. There, it doesn't really call to use it on this character now, does it? Because it kind of doesn't really fit him. Maybe it would if I swapped his staff around. Otherwise, it still is pretty cool. I still really do like it. But you know what that helmet fits perfectly? Is with the neon, like, if we end up ever getting our costume for the neon dragon. I love this suit. But we haven't actually been using him. I want to kind of max out our Ice Mage, and then we'll probably end up swapping back to the Dracolite or maybe another class or something like that. I don't know. But anyway, we're going to call it here, so thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to smack that like button, share, favorite, and subscribe to join Team Pixel. Sign on and stay epic, everybody. Believe in yourself.